your concerns at ease by saying that I do not now, nor have I ever had Ebola.
Well, Pat, let's begin now. So talking of closing borders, I think all four of us in the debate have learned that we need higher Facebook settings. So Brian cannot find photos of us to use to mock us in such situations. And I also realise that for many of you as a Texan American audience, you may be worried about an English person talking about borders. Don't worry, we do not want you back. In fact, under this motion,
people get disease because they are more exposed to it, because they do not have access to basic health care, food, sanitation.
Characterization from the opposition to be like, are you okay staying in Texas for 15 years? I mean, like, maybe. Probably an unlikely scenario, because firstly, quarantine exists. That'll probably take about 2 or 3 weeks, depending upon the disease.
In order to do this, the nation's government, as well as the World Health Organization, would have to pool resources to patrol the border and tighten security. And let's not forget that if Rick Perry can't secure a border, then no one can.
They are correct. The World Health Organization is the proper organization to deal with disease outbreak. Their plan is flawed. Simply closing down borders is not a solution to solving the spread of disease.
Duty upon states to protect their own people. There is a duty on the international community to protect people from the spread of disease. There is no duty on the international community to allow people to go through open borders simply because there is disease in their...
Toronto failed, Vietnam succeeded. The most successful stop of a SARS outbreak occurred in Vietnam, and their method did not include controlling or restricting movement. Instead, prevention tactics such as increased communication, research, mobilization of resources, and education...
Is that tons of people are dying and tons more will die if we don't do this. Surely you should do this, right?